What's going on, guys? So today we're going to review the Ekol Viper blank gun. So here's the carrying case. Cheap plastic, has some warnings on the back. Do not be stupid, basically. Simple stuff. So you got to open it up, these little tabs here. Pretty cheap, they might break on you if you're not careful. Open it up. You get a manual, some flimsy foam which falls around and stuff. And there's the pistol. Now, this is a 22 caliber blank pistol. You normally do not see these Ekol Vipers in 22 caliber. I got mine on a fire sale. Basically, the company I got it from, they couldn't test these guns because of the 22 ammo shortage, so they sell them at a risk of $50, which is half price. So, here's the gun. Full metal construction and everything. Nice heft to it. There's its trademark right there, Ekol Viper 2.5 inch. So it's 2.5 inch barrel model. Tells you the caliber 6mm or 22, but I think it actually might be 24 caliber, 6mm translates to, I don't know. Anyway, made in Turkey, not China. Big plus, that's how I know it's gonna last a long time. It does feel pretty good. It feels solid. So now if you're wondering, hey, you know, if there's a shortage in 22 ammo, what's the use in buying the gun? Well, I got me some nail gun blanks. These are Duo Fast Level 2 nail gun blanks. Now, they don't advise you to use these. I don't see why not. They fit fine. But however, one thing I don't like is they leave a really crappy residue inside the cylinder, which you got to clean every single round, every single batch, or else it'll jam up on you. So back to the gun. Full metal construction, plastic grips. It is single and double action. So it definitely has a good trigger pull to it. It all feels very precise, very well built. There isn't really play in anything. It all seems to be built quite solid. No play in the grips. They don't creak or anything. There's a very, very slight, maybe 0.1 millimeter wobble in the barrel. No big deal. I've put about 50 rounds through this gun. As you can see, it's got its iron sights. The cylinder flips out, pressing the button here, and with your fingers, pop the cylinder out. And that's where you hold your ammo. And it's got a nice ejector feature. However, it does seem like that these nail gun blanks like to get stuck inside the cylinder. You gotta use some force to get them out. And it slaps in pretty nicely. So this is not a front-firing blank gun. Basically, all the gas exits through that top hole and out the sides. There is a block for you from, I don't know, you know, I don't really know the point of that. I guess it's maybe to try to deter you from trying to convert it to a real gun, which you couldn't anyway. I mean, there's just no way. It's just not built for that, even though it does use a similar system. So that is basically all to it. So now once it gets a little darker, we will go take some shots. Okay, so here's how you load it. Pretty simple. Cylinder release forward, index finger, just push it right out like that. Take some of your totally legit, whatever you use. As I said, I'm using these nail gun blanks. Load them into the cylinder at first, during the break-in. Might feel like a bit of a tight fit, but just make sure everything's clean, nothing's obstructing the cylinder, which after you will need to clean after each batch if you are using nail gun blanks. Just like that, and you're good to go. Now, let's go take a few shots. Okay, so now I'm gonna take a few shots with the Ekol Viper. Oof, gotta love the smell of that gunpowder. So you open it up, and as you can see, the cylinder is gonna be a little stiff. But these, there we go. And then see all that residue that came out? That's the crappy residue that these nail gun blanks leave behind. So one drawback, and then you just gotta kinda pick them out. Like so. They do tend to expand. Now, after firing your Ekol Viper blank gun using nail gun blanks, you are going to need to clean it because there's residue behind the cylinder and cylinder star, and that's going to jam up your shit. So, take an old toothbrush, get in there, and just brush all that crap out. It's a little tricky holding the cylinder open and brushing at the same time, but this does work, even though it does make a little bit of a mess. And then once you've done that, your cylinder's clean again, and you're ready for another batch.